Hi everyone, welcome to my channel. Today I'm going to be joining the ladies for Christie's Beautiful Life 30 Days of Sketches Hop. I will go ahead and link everyone participating today down in my description box. Now I am going to be using the sketch that you saw there just a few moments ago, and that is a 12x12 sketch, but I am working in a traveler's notebook insert, which is definitely a lot smaller. So right now I am going to go ahead and trim my photos down as small as I can get them without removing all of the important parts. Because I am limited on space, I want to fit all of the photos in like they are on the sketch. I think there are 5 altogether. There's one larger one, which I have off to the left there, and there's 4 smaller ones. And the smaller ones here, they're not going to be all the same sizes. I am just trimming down all of them as much as I can, like I said before. So I'm going to be using this very old Gossamer Blue Traveler's Notebook insert that I have in my stash. And you can see there, I removed quite a bit of pages from there because I've learned from the past, if I leave too many pages in there and completed all of them, added layouts to all of them, they would just be, my Traveler's Notebook insert would just be too bulky and it will come apart at the seams. So I removed those pages. I'm going to save them though and just add a different cover onto those pages using some pattern paper and create a new insert. So they're not going to go to waste. Now, if you saw my video from yesterday, you saw me go ahead and put together my kit that I'm going to be using for the next 2 months of projects for the fall themed layouts. And it included the pattern paper that you're looking at to the right with all of those cameras. And I also pulled in a lot of my older fall themed stash as well, which includes the paper pad that I'm pulling some papers from right now. And because this is a grid design, I am going to pull 3 different patterns and colors, and I'm going to go ahead and cut them down. Now those squares that I cut out, some of them were 2x2 squares and some of those were 1.5 by 1.5 inch. So they're all not the same size. I just adjusted all of these measurements to suit my traveler's notebook insert layout here and what I felt looked really, really good to me. So basically, I am just using this sketch as inspiration. I am not following it exactly, but the basic design is there, the grid design. Now here I'm going to go ahead and continue cutting out my pattern paper. This one is actually from a very old collection I have in my stash. It's from Studio 40, and there's a lot of alphabets on there, a lot of letters, and they all went really well together, I think, all 3 of these patterns and colors. And now I'm going to pull in some of my newer items here that I showed you guys in my video from yesterday, which I will go ahead and link down below in the description box if you want to check out that kit that I put together. I'm also going to list all of the items I used today down in the description box as well, so you can get the links directly to these items once they're still available online. So there I cut out one of those tags from the Cozy Days collection by Simple Stories, and I'm going to use that exactly where they have it on the sketch to the right side of that photo. Now my paper is white, and I felt once I added those squares it just looked a little naked behind, so I wanted to add a little bit of color that will just peek out from behind all of my squares, my photos and those pattern paper squares. So I'm using some Distress Oxide ink right now with a blending tool, and I'm not being very careful how I blend this at all or add it to my paper. I just want a little bit of color on there. So I added that in. I inked the edges as well. And now I'm going to go ahead and adhere all of my squares and my photos onto my background. Of course, I'm going to use my art glitter glue instead of my ATG. I feel like this holds it a lot better, seeing that there's some type of mixed media on that background already. It holds, it's a little bit stronger, I think. So I'm going to go ahead and use this liquid adhesive and add those all to my background. Here I added in my tag, and you can see I added a piece of twine to the top. I punched a hole and added the twine. And now I am going to work on my title. So I pulled out these very old. Once again, these are so old. I'm so happy I'm getting to use up my oldest stash. And that's one of the things that was my goal once I put together this kit. I wanted to make sure I pulled out all of these older items from my stash and try to get them used up. So I added in the word grade, and I'm going to use some smaller alphas right now and add in third, which would be just the number 3 and RD. Now you can see I had them all nice and straight, but the E would not fit at the bottom without hanging off of the tag. So I went ahead and just add them in all wonky on purpose, and that way they fit. So here I'm going back and forth where I should add in third, and I added it first to the card, to the tag. Then I decided to place it directly on my photo, and once they went on my photo, they're not moving, but I do love how they look there. They are a bit small, but I think it works really well there. So next up, I decided to pull in the word shine from those puffy stickers, those gold puffy stickers, and I'm gonna add that directly on the tag. So now it says shine third grade, and I went in and added the letter R to the bottom of grade, so now it reads shine third grader, which I think it's a lot better title than shine third grade. And these photos are of my grandson on his very first day back to school. And because of COVID, of course, everything is a lot different now. And he is doing virtual school online on Zoom. So these are just a few snapshots of his first day. So I'm pulling in some word phrases now to begin some embellishment clusters. And these are from Pink First Studios. I cannot remember what collection, but I'll add that information down below. I added one that says color outside the lines, good things ahead. And the one to the bottom right corner says think different. Of course, that's what we're doing this year. Everything is pretty much different because of COVID. So here I am pulling in some Studio 40 embellishments, some die cut pieces. I added that diamond that says let's go to the top left corner, but I'll pull that down towards the center of that page in just a few moments. But first I am cutting out one of these cameras, which I'll end up cutting out two actually. And I'm gonna add those to my clusters. I decided to use the green ones. And I'm gonna add the larger one to the bottom photo, next to the bottom photo on the right, and I'm gonna tuck it right under the word phrase there. And here the center here looked a little bit empty. I did not want to add too much, but I decided to go in and add my journaling there, which basically says this was Jaden's first day back, and he of course is all smiles. He was happy he can take his superhero friends to school with him, seeing that he was at home and they sat right next to him while he was doing his Zoom sessions online. So here I cut out a smaller one of those cameras, and that is from an Amy Tangerine collection. I think it's late afternoon, and I got that pattern paper just to cut out all of those cameras. So I think my project later this evening while I'm watching some TV would be to sit and finish cutting them out. It saves a lot of time once I sit down to create if they're already cut out. So here I pulled in another word phrase that says follow your enthusiasm, and I went ahead and just cut it apart so that it would fit really nicely next to that diamond shaped die cut there. And then I will go in and add some enamel dots, and these are from Altenew. And I love these. I decided to use the stars, and I think I used up all of the stars. And on the sketch, there's some splatters. So I went in and added some splatters using my Liquitex Gold Iridescent Acrylic Ink. And I was very careful not to get them on my photos. And here is a close-up shot, a close-up look at my layout. I love how it turned out. Here I have some close-up shots for you guys. I hope you guys enjoy the process today. And don't forget, check out my description box. Lots of information down there. All of the ladies participating will be linked, as well as everything that I use here on my project today. And I want to thank you all for watching. So until my next video, bye.